Should we buy or sell Sprague? First, read this disclaimer carefully and do your good deed of today by liking and subscribing. So we go here to one of the other themes, and that is dividend stocks. 25% here from the 52-week low, so slightly underperforming the S&P 500. Yeah, so here we can find Sprague Resources LP oil and gas, 9% from the 52-week low, minus 54% pullback. So here is the company's website. As your independent natural gas supplier, we'll design solutions for your specific business needs. Okay. So let's just jump into the charts. So this is the big picture weekly data points, and one of the first things we can see very clearly with this stock is that it moves in very, very, very big time cycles. I did try to measure them, but they do differ in duration. But you can see yourself that this is one of those stocks that is very interesting after a significant pullback. That is when you can get some very substantial gains. Like this move here as an example, 87-ish% from this closing low here to this high, 154%, and we are currently at a very low level. It is interesting that we have had multiple weeks here, as you can see with selling. So bears have been very ferocious, but this week we had now something interesting happened. You see here on the wick of the candlestick, you see that we went way lower, but then we close higher. That is the kind of thing that tends to happen when lows are being formed. If you look here at some of the previous sell-offs, like here you can see bears are very much in control, but here you see this interesting action in the wicks. Same thing back here when the low was formed, here as well. So it's interesting from a more speculative bullish perspective. Looking here at the daily data points, the 20-day moving average is offering some resistance. So let's look at the other indicators. So looking at the weekly data points, so throughout the history of this stock, this low end of the RSI, it is very rare, and multiple times in the past, like here, it formed a key low, here it formed a key low, here. Let's zoom in a bit so you can see it. See here, this is this low on the RSI. We did at least get the bounce. Here and here, we did actually go lower. So that's something we have to respect in terms of the RSI. But looking here at the PPO, distance from the 20, 50, 100-week moving average in blue here, it's at a level that has formed lows in the past, especially here at the 50-week moving average. So it's speculatively interesting. Here with the daily data points. So accumulation distribution definitively show that the bears are very much in control. We have been extremely oversold. A distance here from the 200-day moving average is at a level that historically has formed lows in the past, like back here as an example, relatively recently. If we look here at the seasonality of the stock over the last 5 years, we do see that January is one of the strongest months with an average 10% gain. Looking at all the history for this stock, you do see that from November to December, it strengthens significantly. And then January closes higher 88% of the time with an average 6.7% gain. That's very strong seasonality. If I was a short seller, I would not feel comfortable being short this stock into January. Also, March here is an extremely strong month, closing higher 88% of the time. That is just not a good seasonality for a bear, which means it could be very interesting for a bull. So here is Finviz. You can see here, the performance year to date is bad, minus 29%. When we look here at, the SAX, number three hold, but a value and a growth. That is rare. It's very rare for a stock to both have a perfect value score and a growth score. Dividend is 12.9%. Market cap, $353 million. What are the insiders doing? They are accumulation. Buy, 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 buy. They have been buying ever since August. So that is bullish. Yeah, looking here at, the consensus targets, price targets. Okay, then we do not get anything here. If we go here to Finvis, the price targets are very, very old. But all the price targets we do have here are very substantially above the current stock price. So yeah. Yeah, I think that when we take it all together, it looks very interesting. So let's close off here with this, the statistical correlation. Okay. So if you are still watching, then you are one of the big brains that like to look at correlations. So we do have a 53% correlation long term with the S&P 500, so a bit, nothing in particular. 25% with the oil services ETF, OIH, and 33% with the XOP, oil and gas exploration and production. Then minus 65% with the dollar index, short-term correlations. Minus 77% with the S&P 500, 56% with OIH, and minus 19% with the XOP, and then minus 76% with the dollar index. So stronger correlation here, positive with oil services than exploration and production. Okay. So to sum up my take here on this stock, so the dividend here is humongous. So this is definitively a dividend stock. The technicals also suggest that this could be a key low being formed. Some interesting action here on the wick for this week. It's very oversold. So the technical picture here is just very interesting from a bullish perspective. The seasonality is also very bullish for especially for January and March. And then the fundamentals look very good. You literally had a perfect growth and value score at the same time. That is very rare. So there's way more reasons to be bullish than bearish on this stock at this point in time. But of course, we always want to have a stop in place in case things really, really go bad.